Darwin couldn't even get a job. In fact, he was so lazy he wouldn't apply himself that finally his dad stepped in and got him a job. And it was to be a companion for a ship captain as they were floating about near the Galapagos. Now, his role was unpaid, and it was just to give the captain somebody to talk to. And when they landed on the Galapagos, they observed a few finches that had speciated, 14 kinds of finches, and Darwin concluded that just because they had slightly different beak shapes and different anatomical features, that all life shares common ancestry. That you and I and every other living organism descended from a single cell. And this is considered the greatest discovery of all time. And Darwin is often considered the world's number one discoverer.
Bear in mind that our next number one discoverer came across some things in nature that surprised him, and he tried to explain what he saw. It's not the story of a guy just trying to cause trouble. It's the story of the guy who made what you and I consider the number one discovery in science so far.
He said a married man is a poor slave, worse than a After Darwin had made these observations and came to some interesting conclusions, his life took a very dark turn. In fact, he said this about women. Man has ultimately become superior to woman. He said the chief distinction in the intellectual powers of the two sexes is shown by man's attaining to a higher eminence in whatever he takes up than can woman. And it even gets worse. Darwin's book, The Origin of Species, the original title is The Preservation of Favored Races in the Struggle for Life. Darwin believed that certain people groups were inferior to others. He said at some future period, not very distant as measured by centuries, the civilized races of man will almost certainly exterminate and replace the savage races throughout the world. And all of this really explains why he went on to say this. He said a married man is a poor slave, worse than a And later on in Darwin's life, he admitted this. He said, I am very stupid, and I hate everybody and everything. And so it would make sense that he promoted the lie of evolution. Because if he hates people, it's no wonder he came up with such a crazy, wild ideology.
So Bill, Darwin was a big collector. He came up with evolution by natural selection. Could you give us like a 3-minute exposition of Darwin's theory of evolution?
The thing that is fascinating is Charles Darwin wrote this book where he has the theory and the experiments looking at his collections and reaching amazing conclusions.
He said, I am very stupid and I hate everybody.
I'm a biologist and Darwin has been an inspiration to me throughout my whole career.
While secular humanists would have us believe that Darwin was a genius, in reality he was a misogynist, a racist. He hated women, he hated marriage, he hated work, he was afraid he was living in fantasy land, and he admitted to hating everybody and everything. That's the truth. He said, often a cold shudder has run through me, and I have asked myself whether I have devoted myself to a fantasy. And so Darwin was afraid that everything he believed was based on a fantasy. Now, this just shows us that he didn't actually believe in scientific law, because if he did, he wouldn't be afraid that he was living in fantasy land. People can come up with their own opinions about Darwin, and they can continue to claim that he's a wonderful man and a scientific genius, but in reality, Darwin hated life, he hated you and I, he hated Jesus, and that's why he spoke out against Christianity. The sad truth about Darwin is that he actually was supposed to be a man of God. His dad always wanted him to be a preacher and somebody that would spread the truth of God's word to the public. But Darwin got involved with the wrong crowd of people, and he got involved with the wrong ideologies, and he let Satan take over his life, and that's when everything took a turn for the worst in his existence.
This is the most precious book in my collection. It's a genuine first edition, Origin of Species. But it's not just the most precious book in my library. Charles Darwin's Origin of Species is one of the most precious books in the entire library of our species. This book made it possible no longer to feel the necessity to believe in anything supernatural. It completely revolutionized the way we see ourselves, the world, and our origins.
And the genius who thought of it was Charles Darwin. I'm a biologist, and Darwin has been an inspiration to me throughout my whole career.
Looking at his collections and reaching amazing conclusions.
Darwin's father paid for his voyage,
Bruh.
And also paid for an assistant
Bruh.
To come with Darwin and help him skin the specimens and prepare the crates for shipment. He worked in a little poop deck where he had all his specimens. He was the first to popularize the idea of the tree of life, in which we're related to all living things.